ولا ينفعهم ويقولون هؤلاء شفعاؤنا عند الله. And they worship besides Allah. Those who neither harm them nor benefit them. And they say, these are our intercessors with Allah. قُلْ أَتُنَبِّئُونَ اللَّهَ بِمَا لَا يَعْلَمُ فِي السَّمَوَاتِ وَلَا فِي الْأَرْضِ. Say, do you inform Allah? Do you teach Allah concerning that which He doesn't know in the heavens and the earth? سُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ عَمَّا يُشْرِكُونَ. How perfect is Allah above those they worship along with Him. Allah called it shirk. They're saying, we're only seeking shafa'ah through them. Allah did not accept that. Allah did not accept that. He called it kufr and shirk. So what are we supposed to do? Once you call on someone, once you say, Ya Fulan, Ya Rifa'i, Ya Jilani, Ya Muhammad, once you call Ya, the same way you say Ya Allah, you have worshipped this person, period. Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Inna du'a'a huwa al-ibadah. Verily, dua is ibadah. Is ibadah. And we will see the ayah. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, Ud'uni, listen now. Ud'uni, call on me, astajib lakum. Innal ladhina yastakbiruna an ibadati sayadukhuluna jahannama dakhirin. Allah said, look at the ayah. Call on me, I will respond to you. Then what did he say? Verily, those who disdain, who are too arrogant to worship me, they will enter Jahannam in humiliation. So Allah said, you call on me, then He said, when you don't call on Him, meaning you're doing what? You're not doing ibadah. Meaning when you're calling Allah, you're doing ibadah of Allah Azza wa Jal. So there's no excuse. Nahr, slaughtering is for who? Fasalli lirabbika wanhar. To Allah alone, pray and sacrifice. Once you sacrifice to someone along with Allah, you have committed shirk. Look, Allah does not even accept. It does not. Allah doesn't even accept that you worship others with Him in your niyyah, in your riya, showing off. If you do a deed seeking Allah's pleasure and the people, Allah will not accept it. Let alone sacrificing an animal or calling on someone who's dead. Let alone ibadah of du'a. If Allah doesn't accept showing off, He will not accept that good deed. Then what do you say about this? What do you say about this? Allah ajib. So, Allah, let me give you some ayat so we will really remember Tawheed in our lives. وَأَنَّ الْمَسَاجِدَ لِلَّهِ فَلَا تَدْعُوا مَعَ اللَّهِ أَحَدًا. Every place of prostration belongs to Allah. Don't worship anyone with Allah. لَا تَدْعُوا مَعَ اللَّهِ أَحَدًا. يا أخي والله I don't understand, man. I don't understand what do these people want. Allah says don't call on anyone besides Allah, and these people insist on calling on others with Allah. Allah is telling us, don't do that. This is shirk, this is kufr, you will go to Jahannam. And they insist on the same acts, and then they call the people of Sunnah and the people of Tawheed all kinds of names. Allah says, أَمَّا يُجِيبُ الْمُطَّرَّ إِذَا دَعَاهُ وَيَكْشِفُ السُّءُ. Then who is it that will respond to the one who is distressed when he calls on him? And he will alleviate affliction. Who is it? Allah. At the end of the ayah, it says, أَإِلَاهُمْ مَعَ اللَّهِ. Is there any other gods with Allah? Do you do anyone else but Allah alleviates the harm? Wallahi, these Sufis and these grave worshippers, they call on these dead people asking them, my son broke his leg, I need increase in my salary. They send them letters, they call on them and send their requests to dead people. The same shirk which they're supposed to abandon and leave alone, had they asked Allah, everything would have been fine. Yani they think, I don't understand. Look what Allah says. لَهُ دَعْوَةُ الْحَقِّ وَالَّذِينَ يَدْعُونَ مِن دُونِهِ لَا يَسْتَجِيبُونَ لَهُمْ بِشَيْءٍ. Allahu Akbar. To Allah belongs the supplication of truth. And those whom they call on besides Him do not respond to them with anything. Nothing. Look at this ayah. إِن تَدْعُوهُمْ لَا يَسْمَعُوا دُعَاءَكُمْ وَلَوْ سَمِعُوا مَا اسْتَجَابُوا لَكُمْ وَيَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ يَكْفُرُونَ بِشِرْكِكُمْ. Allah said, if you call on them, they do not hear you. If you call on them, they do not hear you. And if they heard you, they will not respond to you. And on the Day of Judgment, they will declare their disbelief from your shirk. They will say, Wallah, oh Allah, Wallah, Abdul Qadir al-Jilani is a righteous man. He will say, oh Allah, I had nothing to do with it. Just like Isa ibn Maryam. Just like Isa ibn Maryam will declare his innocence. I didn't say to them except what you told me. اعبدوا الله ربي وربكم. Worship Allah, my Lord and your Lord. But the people took Jesus as a God. Muslims fell into the same trap of the Christians. And it's at least Jesus is a prophet. They may be worshiping the most wicked of people. So Allah says, وَمَنْ أَضَلُّ مِمَّنْ يَدْعُ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ مَنْ لَا يَسْتَجِيبُ لَهُ إِلَى يَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ وَهُمْ عَنْ دُعَائِهِمْ غَافِلُونَ. Who is more astray than he who calls on besides Allah one who does not respond to him and for until the day of judgment, and they concerning their dua are unaware. They're unaware. Can this apply to anyone but the dead? If you called on a living person, would he be aware or unaware? He'll be aware. When Allah says they're unaware about their ibadah, this must be statues and dead people. La ilaha illallah. So we say, the kuffar of Quraysh and the Muslims who are engaged in kufr today, they have no excuse to say, well, we are Muslims because we say La ilaha illallah. Guess what? The hypocrites, the munafiqun, did they say La ilaha illallah? Did they say Muhammadur Rasulullah? Did they pray in jama'ah? Did they go for jihad? Yes. And did Allah accept them as Muslims? No. What did Allah say about them? إِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ فِي الدَّرْكِ الْأَسْفَلِ مِنَ النَّارِ. The hypocrites will be in the lowest level of the fire. And when they made fun of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the Sahaba, when they only were joking with each other and on the way of one of the battles, they said, we haven't seen anyone like our Qurra, bigger bellies and more coward. And more, you know, more they were more cowards at the time of confronting the enemies. We haven't seen anything like our Qurra. Referring to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the Sahaba, Allah revealed the Quran. قُلْ أَبِاللَّهِ وَآيَاتِهِ وَرَسُولِهِ كُنْتُمْ تَسْتَهْزِئُونَ لَا تَعْتَذِرُوا قَدْ كَفَرْتُمْ بَعْدَ إِيمَانِكُمْ. Say concerning Allah, His ayat, His signs, His miraculous signs and verses, and His messenger, you were mocking. Do not apologize. You have disbelieved after your iman. Allah called them kuffar because what? They made fun of some of the Sahaba. But they were saying what? La ilaha illallah. Didn't the Sahaba fight against Banu Hanifa? Not Imam Abu Hanifa. Some people when they hear Abu Hanifa ala tul, you know the thing goes up, right? The radar or the gauge. You know, bam, Abu Hanifa rahimahullah. We love him, don't worry. We love him. Wahhabis love Imam Abu Hanifa. They have no problems with him. Just in case you thought. Because they tell you, you know, we are the Hanafis and this, and then these are the Wahhabis and everything else. They try to make this distinction. There are positions which we the people of Sunnah follow that only Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah has. The Hanabila, Shafi'iyya, Malikiyya don't have it. And we follow the Hanafi madhab in that particular area because we are people who go with the Hadith. Whatever the Hadith takes us, we are on the same journey. That's our attitude. And that's the most beautiful thing in the world. Anyways, Allah declared them disbelievers. The Sahaba fought against Banu Hanifa. What happened to Banu Hanifa? Does anyone know? They were Muslims, doing everything. Then this guy Musaylama, Al-Kadhab, came and said, I'm a prophet. They believed them. They became kuffar. So you can disbelieve after saying La ilaha illallah. So now these people say, Wallah, I say La ilaha illallah. That means I must be a Muslim. You cannot say I'm doing kuffar. Say, brother, or inshallah you will become a brother, or maybe you're a brother. Once you are doing the act of shirk, that doesn't guarantee you Islam. Islam has an entrance and an exit. You come in from this door and you can leave from that one. It's not like once you come into Islam, you're trapped. You can leave easily. You can come easily and you can leave easily. Unless you maintain the Tawheed. So they have absolutely no excuse. So in finality, I say,